Hello everyone, my name is Sherry and today I'll be conducting the Georgia ETR training.
The website that you're going to need to log in order to process an electronic title and registration deal is georgia.titletech.com. So you can spell out georgia.titletech.com. You're going to enter your username and your password.
Once you log in, there's going to be a pop-up that comes up every time you log in. Please review the pop-up warning. It's going to say, warning, your immediate attention is needed. Your business is at risk of being fined $100 for each document images that have not been received by the Department of Revenue. Please access the document listing notification at the top of the main screen for more details. When you log into TitleTech, there's going to be two buttons that you need to review every single day. The first button is any deal that you finalize in TitleTech. It tells you how many days you have left to get that deal to your scanning center so you are not charged a penalty. Anytime you change an address for a customer in TitleTech, this is the home button. You want to click that button so you know how many days you have left to get that form into your scanning center so you are not charged a penalty. The green means you have deals that have already been sent to the scanning center. Red means that you're going to be penalized for those deals if you don't get them into your scanning center. And there's a splash page. Every time you log in, you want to make sure you read the splash page. Important notice to dealers, please read. It has the different ETR training videos as well as any state mandated forms. So you want to make sure you review this page every day as well as the ETR paperwork. It has your scanning information facility information on this page as well as all the required documents. So I suggest you review that page every day. So you have two options once you log into the system. You have new tops only deal. You only do a new tops only deal for someone that lives out of state or qualify for a TABT exemption. There is a mandatory ETR bulletin, and I'm just going to go over which transactions cannot be processed through the ETR system. Anyone that is a disabled veteran and qualify for an exemption cannot be processed through ETR. So you would need to do a TOPS only deal for that veteran and walk the deal into the county tag office. If you have someone that is a non-resident service member, you would do a TOPS only deal and walk that deal into the county. Trucks and charter buses registered under the International Registration Plan cannot be processed through the ETR system. Vehicles purchased by government entities, you will not process through the ETR system. Loaner vehicles cannot be processed through ETR, and vehicles registered in the dealership's name. So make sure you are not processing these deals as an ETR deal. A TOPS only deal cannot be converted to an ETR deal. So if a customer lives in Georgia and has a Georgia driver's license or Georgia identification card, you always click on new ETR deal. If you have a dealer management software system, TitleTech does integrate with different dealer management software systems where it would import the information from your DMS. That's why there's an import from DMS. Otherwise, you're going to have to manually type in the information. So dealership, of course, is going to be your dealership. Your deal number, it can be any deal number you choose. It's just a unique identifier to identify your deal number in TitleTech. When processing information, you have three choices. You have cash deal, you have finance deal, and you have lease deal. The system does have a trade-in vehicle where if someone is trading in the vehicle, it does bring up a trade-in tab. On the trade-in tab, you will have to add the trade-in vehicle.
You will add the bin number. The system does a bin explosion where it will automatically load the year, make, model, and knows whether or not that title is a Georgia title or out-of-state title. The only thing you would have to add is the color, the miles, and the title number. If a customer trades in a vehicle, make sure that customer is the owner on the title. And you will also need to add in the trade-in amount right here for the amount that you're allowing the customer that's trading in the vehicle. If you are a buy here, pay here dealer, you must let Title Tech know and send in your letter so you can get the buy here, pay here discount. If you finance 90% of your deals in-house, if the contract is 24 months or longer, and you have an ELT number, you can qualify for a 2.5% discount of TABT. But you must let Title Tech know so they can add that button. So if you are a buy here, pay here dealer, you will select yes if it's going to be a finance deal that you're going to do in a house. Next is going to be the sales information. The sales date is going to be the date you sell the vehicle. Factory rebate is for new cars, so you will put zero if it is a used car deal. Sales price is going to be the price that you're selling the vehicle before any TABT taxes, before any title fees. Used car book value, the system has a built-in fair market value calculator, but for some reason, if the system does not calculate the fair market value based on the VIN number, you will have to enter the retail selling price or NADA base trade-in value, whichever is higher. Next is going to be the vehicle screen. VIN number, very important. You want to make sure that you're entering the correct VIN number. Once you load the VIN number, you cannot correct the VIN number. So if you do load the incorrect VIN number, you will have to cancel the deal and load another deal with the correct VIN number. Title Tech will charge you a $5 fee to cancel that deal. So once you enter the VIN number, you select load vehicle. The system does a VIN explosion where it will automatically record year, make, model, body style, engine type, vehicle status. New MSO is for new vehicles, new manufacturer state of origin. The system knows based on the VIN number where it is a new MSO, used Georgia title, or used out-of-state title. The only thing you would have to enter is the body color, because there's so many different types of colors. You would have to manually enter the body color. Fuel type is going to be needed, but the system will enter that for you. Your stock number is not required or gross vehicle weight. Only the fields in red are required. Odometer. If the vehicle miles are exempt, you must enter zero for the odometer and exemption exempt. If you have a vehicle where the true miles are not known or an actual mileage is not known, you still have to enter zero for the miles, but under exemption, you will select not actual mileage. Title information. Until you get the actual physical title, you will be pending the deal and printing out the temporary tag. Once you get the physical title is when you will add the title information. The system will only accept 15 digits for the title number, so make sure you only enter 15 digits and you have to select the title state. There is a National Motor Vehicle Title Information System reference chart if you ever want to know where to locate the title number for each state. We do have that on our website as well. Title brands, the system does allow you to add title brands. If you have a Georgia rebuilt title, for example, you would select the title brand rebuilt. If you have a bonded title, you would select the title brand bonded. Or if you have a court order title, that's when you would select that title brand. But the physical title must have that title brand on there. Next is going to be the owner screen. The system does allow you to add two owners. An individual can be an owner or a business can be an owner. You have two options.
If the business is an owner, you do not need the customer ID number. If it's an individual that is an owner, you can load the individual information based on their driver's license number. Once you enter their driver's license number, their name will appear. The system is going to bring up their name based on GRATIS. GRATIS is the Georgia Registration and Title Information System. If the customer name doesn't match their license, you must check this button, customer name does not match license. The system will do an inquiry with the Department of Driver's License Services to match up the name to make sure it's the correct name that appears on their license. Next is going to be residential address. The system will pull up the customer's address based on their last tax liability or county registration. So if the customer address is not the correct address, you must edit the address. You will be charged a dollar fee to edit the address. You're only going to edit the residential address. You will type in the customer's address, you're going to click verify, update, an MV-34 form pops up. That is a change of address affidavit form. Your scanning center must have this form as soon as possible so we can scan it to the Department of Revenue so you are not charged any penalty fees for that form. Once you add the address and update it, the system will update it with the Department of Revenue. Now, the system does allow a one-time mailing address where you can have plates mailed to an address other than where the customer lives at. This does not change the customer's residential address. It's only allowing you to send a plate to a customer as a courtesy to this one-time address. If there is a cash deal, and the customer wants their title sent to an address other than their residential address, you can do a one-time mailing address for the title. This does not change the customer residential address. This is just a one-time mailing address that the title will be mailed to from the Department of Revenue. The system allows you to add two owners. The system only accepts Georgia driver's license or Georgia identification cards. So the second owner, in order to add them in the system, must have a Georgia ID or Georgia driver's license. Next is going to be the lien holder screen. There are so many different lien holders in Georgia. Anybody that's ever done business in Georgia is listed as a lien holder. As of right now, there are 5,814 lien holders. You can add up to two lien holders. In order to add a lien holder, a title clerk or admin must check this box to approve the lien holder. The system allows you to add your favorite lien holders. So if you have frequent lien holders that you use, you can add them to your favorite lien holder, so you can just select your favorite lien holder every time you do a deal instead of having to search the lien holder list. If you do not know the lien holder information, you can always search the lien holder list, or you can search by state. The system allows you to search different lien holders in the state. If you have someone that is an individual, they can also be the lien holder on a title. You would have to input the individual's information and they will get a printed title from the Department of Revenue. If you have a business that is not an ELT lender, you can manually add the business information and they will get a printed title from the Department of Revenue. Next is going to be the review screen. Very important, I suggest you review the information 2 to 3 times. You want to review your deal information, your vehicle information, your owner information, as well as the lien information. Next is going to be the submit button. Once you load a deal, you'll be able to print the temporary tag, have the plate sent to the customer, or transfer a plate. You have 3 options in TitleCheck. It will have the customer's registration county selected once you put in the information. Title only,
That's only if the customer is going to pay and pick up their tag at their local tag office. You will select title only. Temporary plate will be any temporary plate that's in your bin. Insurance type is going to be binder, unless it is a fleet deal, and you would pin the ETR deal and print the temporary tag. New plate and title, the system does allow you to send the plate to the customer. There is a $20 plate fee and a $5 mail convenience fee in order to have the plate sent to the customer. You have up to 115 options. Most of the time it's going to be passenger cars like trucks, but customers can select different types of specialty plates. Your registration period is always going to be one. Temporary plate will be the next available top tag in your bin. Insurance type is going to be binder. And if you're not ready to finalize the deal, you want to pin the ETR deal and print the temporary tag. Next is transfer plate. If someone has a plate they want to transfer, the system does allow you to transfer their plate. You enter their plate number, registration period is going to be one. You still have to print them a tag because they have to wait till they get their new decal in order to put on the plate that they're transferring. Insurance type is going to be binder, and you will pin the ETR deal. This abort ETR creates standalone tops only. That's only if you made a mistake and you entered an ETR deal instead of a tops only deal. Remember, tops only deals are for customers that are out of state or someone that qualifies for a TABT exemption. Next, I will show you a pending deal so you'll know exactly where you go in order to print the top tag. So here's an example of a pending deal. On the submit button, once the deal is pending, you will scroll down to forms and applications and you will select print the temporary tag. The temporary tag is valid for 45 days. You only have 30 days to finalize the deal through the ETR system, so you are not charged a penalty. The system will hold your deal for 59 days, but remember, on the 31st day, you will be charged a TABT penalty as well as a late title fee penalty. As long as the deal is pending, you are not charged any fees. You can edit the pending deal as much as possible. If someone backs out of a sale and you need to cancel the pending deal, there is a $5 fee that TitleTech will charge you to cancel the pending deal, but that is an option. You are not charged any fees until you actually finalize the deal. So as long as the deal is pending, you'll see the fees that you're going to be charged. The title and registration fee, Georgia's title fee is $18. There is a $20 tag fee and a $5 mailing plate fee. TABT tax is 7% of the fair market value of the vehicle unless you are a buy here, pay here dealer. And you collect 4.5% of TABT from the customer. Once you're ready to finalize the deal, that's when you would actually hit the finalize deal button. And next, I'm going to show you a finalize deal so you'll know exactly what forms are needed once you finalize the deal. So on the submit tab, under forms and available actions, once you finalize the deal, you'll have to print a T21 cover sheet. This is similar to the lien receipt or motor vehicle receipt that you receive at the county tag office when you process somebody's registration. It has your dealership information, the vehicle information, the owner information, lien information, as well as fees. So you're going to know exactly what you're being charged on every deal, the TABT fee, the title fee, as well as the tag fee if you're going to have a tag sent to the customer. Submit the following completed documents in order as they apply to the vehicle. Everything that's highlighted in bold is a required document. The other documents are only applicable when they're needed. Of course, on every deal, we're going to need a T21 cover sheet. This is the T21 cover sheet. MB1 title application, that is required on every deal. We must have the original Georgia title, out-of-state title, or new manufacturer state of origin. A dealer reassignment form that is only applicable if you did not use the title to show the transfer of ownership. Power of attorney form that's only used if you signed your name on behalf of the customer on the MV1 or the title. If you use a secure power of attorney form to sign on behalf of the customer, that's when we would need that form. On every deal, we're going to need a bill of sale, we're going to need a purchase agreement or a lease agreement. Lien release, that's only required if the customer on the front of the title paid off the vehicle. There is a lien release placed on the front of a Georgia title. If the lien was not released on the front of a Georgia title, there is a T4 form, which is a lien release form. Affidavit of repossession. If the customer on the front of the title, if the vehicle was repossessed from that customer, you will need a T16, which is an affidavit of repossession. Odometer discrepancy affidavit. That form is only needed if you made a mistake on the miles on the back of the title. There is a T107 form, which is the name of the odometer discrepancy affidavit. Affidavit of correction, that is a T11 form. If you have a customer that backed out of the deal, or if the seller signed in the wrong place or the buyer signed in the wrong place, that's where you would need an affidavit of correction to explain the correction that you made on the assignment on the title. An affidavit of correction cannot be used for a lien release or a odometer discrepancy. Inheritance documents, letters of testimony, letters of administration, death certificate, marriage certificate, divorce decree, or legal name change. If any of those documents came with your title documents, please send them in. They're not always applicable. Next is another required document, photocopy of driver's license. We must have a photocopy of every owner on this purchasing the vehicle. We must have the driver's license or Georgia identification card. The MV34 form, that is the change of address form, that form comes before any documents. We must have that form as soon as possible so you are not charged a penalty. We have to scan that form in to the Department of Revenue within 15 days so you are not charged a $5 penalty fee. If the Department of Revenue does not get that change of address form within 45 days, they will charge you $100 in addition to the $5 penalty fee. Anytime you finalize a deal and title to it, you must submit the documents to your scanning center within 8 days so we can review those documents. We have to have your document scanned to the Department of Revenue within 15 days so you are not charged a late penalty fee of $5. If we don't get your document scanned to the Department of Revenue within 45 days of the date of finalization, you will be charged a $100 fee in addition to the $5 fee. If you finalize a deal with incorrect information, you can only void the deal the same day by midnight. Otherwise, once it gets to your QA scanning center and they notice that there is an error, we must have the Department of Revenue to correct their error, and they're going to charge you a $15 document error fee. So I just explained when to use a TOPS only deal, when to do a new ETR deal. So you have access to your inventory like you always had in the old TOP system. So if you need to order inventory, you would click on the inventory tag, order TOP tags. If you need to add them to your bin, there is the option to add them to your bin. My settings, if you need to add favorite lien holders, you can do that under my settings. If you need to be able to set user restrictions, you can do that through my settings. If you need to add your static IP address, that's IP lockdown, it's right there available. And you also have access to Title Tech packs and e-forms. I'm going to show you a finalized deal so you'll know exactly where to go to look for the free e-forms.
after the submit button, there is e-forms. If you ever need any of the affidavits of corrections, repossessions, all these forms are free of charge. The scanning tab is for you. We're going to be your scanning facility once you sign up for ETR. So if you need to review the documents that we have scanned, you will click on the scanning tab. Once the deal is sent to the Department of Revenue, you will be able to go to the scanning tab and see the date that your QA center received the documents, the date they sent them to the state, and you'll be able to click on the View tab. The View tab downloads all the documents that was sent from your scanning center to the Department of Revenue on your deal. So it's going to have your T21 cover sheet, it's going to have your MB1 form, it's going to have the title, any documents that came with the title, reassignment form, your bill of sale, and your customer's driver's license. Anytime you do a change of address, you can also go to the scanning tab to either download the change of address form or to see if the address form has been sent to the Department of Revenue. So you do have access to that. Under reports, if you ever need to look at your billing statement, you can go to reports, financial reports, click on your dealer statement. You select your dealership name. You can select the start date. It will show how much you're going to be charged on every single deal, so you have access to reports. Under process deals, if you need to know which deals are finalized, you can search your deals. You have to search your dealership name, deal status. You can search all statuses, or you can also search by my deals if you need to be able to look up a deal for your dealership. Under tools, the system does have where you can pull the Georgia Registration and Title Information System. You can do a customer inquiry. You can do a vehicle inquiry. There is a fee for the inquiry, as well as you have access to the National Motor Vehicle Title Information System report. There is a fee for pulling this report, but you do have that option under the tools menu. The system does have a free VIN decode. It lets you, takes you directly to the Department of Revenue website if you need to get a free form. There is a TABT daily report that allows you to select your dealership, see which deals were finalized, and see the report for today for that dealership. So you do have that access through the system. And there's also a fair market value calculator where it takes you directly to the Department of Revenue. You can load the VIN number if you're not familiar with what the TABT is going to be on that vehicle. So you do have access to all of these options. And if you ever need to call live support, their number is 855-336-9023. And that concludes my ETR training. Thank you and have a great day.